love from love, hope from hope, peace from peace, and the prince thereof. Dove's benevolence, the Lord is sending through his Holy Spirit, voice of truth. And his benevolence is an amazing glory of love that's ahead of us. Charity for all, and all are uplifted. No one is condemned as long as they keep their light of love alive. This was the mystery of God that has always transcended all religion, whether people wanted to believe that or not. So let love pave the way and make a way in the wilderness as his love shines eternally over all of his children of love, who can now receive their inheritance according to the kingdom age covenant of Jeremiah 31, that's revealed as the kingdom age covenant and literal for all mankind, to promise them peace and love so that 1,000 years of peace can come, as Isaiah 2 has foretold, for the latter days. And these are those latter days. The latter days of the Habakkuk 2, King James, has come. The vision has been for this appointed time. In the end, it has come, and the just shall live by this faith of love. And the dove's benevolence yells out volumes of love and charity for all people so that his spirit can be poured out over all flesh. But let Zion not be shocked, for awe is the Lord's name, and startling souls caught off guard is no game that he ever tries to win. For Yahweh has never lost, nor ever will. So love always wins, and so shall his will always be accomplished. Neither can his love ever fail, for it dives deeper than a cormorant, a bird diving like a stork, and it goes far deeper than an anime in the ocean grows, while even transcending the deepest of oceans. Therefore shall Elohim, Adonai, Allah always bless all those whom he calls, all of love, and he calls us all. And he calls all that he has set apart for his service of love. The golden rule, that is the religion of love. And let that be shouted to the heavens as the everlasting gospel once again goes forth to all creation, to all mankind, exactly as Revelation 14 foretold. And he is setting everyone apart for his service of love that will listen to his voice. And everything they want is on the other side of his very best blessedness that he now is with open hands handing to all who will receive. People, pass out these videos of mine. Love your brother as yourself. That is the religion of love. And this is the one world religion of John 10:16, for he stands as the good shepherd over all, and all may now hear his voice of unconditional love, and their names are all engraved upon his heart. And his beloved, the Lion of Zion, shall have him imbued with poetry in their thoughts of his constant worship, as they realize his love has been so unfathomable and deeper than they've ever imagined. And then shall his heart be touched by their tenderness after they finally become as one by adjoining their voices together, which shall never stop calling out his majestic name. He is the majesty of majesties and the icon of icons, and he is love. And happily shall he always be their God, exactly as Jeremiah 32:27. I am the God of all mankind. And in this day, in these latter days of the covenant of Israel having been given, exactly as it is written in Jeremiah 30:24 and Jeremiah 31:1. In these latter days, God's love is so great for us, providing mercy and warmth for our needs, that he says, I shall return my terrifying anger and stop the fast rising great tribulation if you will all start just giving a little bit of love. That's all he's looking for. And he wants to be a cloud of glory to hover around all of those calling him Father, as a mother, El Shaddai, shall cover them with his very best well wishes of love. And love shall be the blanket that they cover themselves up with. And then shall the wise bathe within the milky vapor of the silvery mist that's only seen by those who have learned that love is a choice and not a feeling. And as a hand clasp of a lover shall he love, being tightly knit and in an eternal embrace of his mind, calling out to his wisest children of obedience, who dares to call him theirs. He is ours, and he calls us beloved, as we shall now call him. Let new psalms of Yahweh's love shine brighter than the heavens, for the sun of righteousness arises exactly as it is foretold in Isaiah 60. So the gross darkness may fade away, so the world will never be misled by the worry about false prophets anymore. For all who love are born of God and know God, because God is love. Even the one that would die by a sword and become the Antichrist, Revelation 13:13. Even Morgue official, the sword swallower, who has started his new Hyperion religion of atheists, he has his love light on now. And those who walk with the Spirit in love are under no condemnation. So the mystery of God has been that the false prophet thing has never been of any importance, because he's looked upon our hearts in love. So praise the Lord. He alone is worthy to be praised and exalted far beyond heaven. Most affectionate should every enlightened child of the King always be towards his faithless, towards his faithfulness. I can't say it. For it is written that he is married to the backslider, and no man or the banished devil himself in these days of Daniel 12, he's in the pit, people, because he cannot be the accuser of the brethren anymore. Not even that old discarded guy can ever take anyone out of the Lord of Lords' hands, which holds the cares of every man. So let the faithful receive his blessings as kisses, and his chastisements as well as well-deserved punishments that we bring on to ourselves, for he sends no judgment upon us. But during this hour of the trial of all flesh, Revelation 3 foretold COVID, he's sending a word of patience to keep us from the hour of the temptation not to change. For together we stand, divided we shall fall. And these are the days of the one world religion of love. And in that day of John 10:16, he asserts his lordship of Jeremiah 32:27 over all mankind. And he says to all mankind, beloved, he loves you. And that is the message he sends. So let the faithful receive his very best blessings as kisses and his chastisements. For as a natural father rebukes not his children, they are not but as bastards unto them. And their love is shallow as a shadow if they care not. There's no such thing worse in this world than indifference in regards to love. It cuts like a knife. I know I've been stabbed by all of my children and by my wife, whom I love, and I pray they shall yet repent. But they're at odds against my faith of love. Petty hatred flows not from the Lord. There's nothing petty about him, people. So it's time to arise and wake up, because echoes of animosity streaming from Cain and Abel are still bouncing around and in between all of those who are saying that they serve that they don't serve the same Lord. It's backwards. There is only one God, and his name is love. For those who love are born of God and know God. So if your love light is on, you know God. Just like fish might not know they're in water, but it's the life that gives them sustenance. We might not think we know him, but he is love that keeps us alive. Unity of man. These are the days of John 10:16. And he arises in all glory, and the light at the end of the tunnel is his. And anyone that doesn't see this are sick, and they're very thin-skinned people that disagree on so many things, on so many levels to count, and they lay awake on thinking how they can control those opposing their own beliefs. Let all the insanity stop. Let's get off the bus and let forgiveness now become the grave markers of all martyrs of all religions. As all men beat their swords into instruments, then shall they lovingly gather the Lord's very last harvest of earth in peacefulness, as all war is forgotten. And I, Daniel, the latter day Daniel of Daniel 12:13, shall be as the mortar over the leaders of all the world, as the Lord gives and roars out the command, peace be still, lower now all the nuclear arms. The light has come.